An uncharted island.
Let me list all the ways you're gonna die. Rain, heat, disease-carrying flies, and we haven't started on the things that want to eat you alive.
We'll double that.
An all-star cast journeys into dangerous territory in search of the secrets of Kong Skull Island.
I love Kong. So many people do, I think. He's an icon. He's a myth of modern-day movies. And it was a real privilege that we get to be part of the legacy of Kong movies and tell it in our own way, put a fresh spin on the idea, and go to some beautiful places.
We're an okay part of the film, but the integral part of the film is getting the big things right. You gotta get Kong, you gotta get the other things, you gotta get the mysteries and scary things on the island right. Because people are coming to see Kong. They're not coming to see us necessarily. I mean, we're fodder.
Skull Island is set against the waning days of the Vietnam War, with the majority of filming taking place in that country.
From the second we arrived, I felt like we were part of just like an incredible piece of history, being there and working alongside the Vietnamese people. We all just really loved it a lot. I mean, we got to travel. I think we traveled like every week or every 3 days to a different part. So I got to see a lot of really beautiful places.
No spoilers, but don't expect Brie Larson to do a Fay Wray imitation.
I like the fact that we didn't use Brie as Kong bait or as a necessarily romantic attachment to Tom's character. She may be the strongest person in the film.
Reporting from Skull Island, or rather, in Hollywood, I'm Rick Damigella.